My name is James Carley. I'm an American democracy and liberty activist who's worked in issues of sustainable development and drug policy. I've been monitoring the Kurdish situation on Twitter, and it breaks my heart. The Kurds absolutely deserve an independent nation. They've suffered for too long under the rule of other people. From an American perspective, it's complex and challenging. You have a lot of support in the U.S. Congress for Kurdish independence, which is fantastic. From a long-term grand strategy perspective, an independent Kurdistan would threaten to cleave the Persian people who the United States will need on their side once the Ayatollah's regime in Iran is done. So the United States has to be careful with Kurdistan, because if they support an independent Kurdistan too much, then it could cause fissures in Iranian society and build even deeper resentment among the Iranian youth, who are actually quite pro-US, pro-American relations. So from a long-term foreign policy perspective of the United States has to strike a right balance for managing the Shia and Kurds, the Shia and Sunni split. And siding too heavily with the Kurds could complicate that even more than it is. It's a mess right now. But in the heart of hearts, Kurdistan deserves independence. The Kurdish people deserve liberty. And I am impressed with Kurdish efforts to propagate soft power and build relationships with American leadership.
I have concerns about the Hashid militias and the Shia militias seizing key infrastructure in cities in the Kurdish border regions. It further advances the completion of the road to Damascus from Tehran. Exactly right. I'm not sure I understand enough about the details you just mentioned, but it is, I mean, we've seen a complete abandonment of diplomacy by the Trump administration. Rex Tillerson's poor leadership of the State Department is watching American diplomacy and almost 200 years of statecraft and world leadership crumble before our eyes. And as someone who aspires to American diplomacy myself, it's heartbreaking. And I'm aware that my role in my career will be rebuilding America's credibility in the world instead of helping to make the world a better place from an American perspective, and that's a tragedy. I don't know too much. I understand that he's a lawyer by profession and not a military man, but I understand that Brett McGurk, from how I understand it, is that he is really wed to the idea of Iraqi federalism and Iraqi constitutional federalism. And while the Kurds have had a say and have demanded many important concessions in the Iraqi constitution, at the same time, American leaders